Hey guys, welcome to Redbeard Outdoors. We just finished up in Nebraska at our summer camp where we did our bird dog training, and we made our way down to the Durango, Colorado area, and we're camping at a very remote cabin in the middle of nowhere in the San Juan National Forest. While we were here, I got to test out my solar system, and that's our main source of power on the trailer, and it did great, other than when it stormed up here quite a bit. And then when it was too cloudy, we had to run our generator. This was a vacation, so I didn't do much commentary, but I took the camera along and ended up filming a lot of things. We ventured over to New Mexico, Arizona, Utah, and Colorado while we were here, and did a lot of sightseeing and a lot of touristy stuff. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode and come along for this adventure.
I'm getting good footage.
Liking the speed though. This is her kind of speed.
Thank you. I'm driving my team. This one's Pringles and this is Harmony.
Was a member of the Relief Society. She was 29 years old when she arrived in Bluff. When sickness came upon the people, she quickly demonstrated her ability as a nurse. In Bluff, a bumper...
Actually, right here is a good one because you got it. That way you can see your screen and.
I'm pretty tired. I think I'll go home now.
I'm pretty tired. think I'll go home now.
Approaching to watch you look like you just can't stand down, Trump. Have you ever seen one of those up here?
No, never.
Two of them.
you all notice the chinking stones in the mortar here? Yep. Yes.
The fact that they did not plaster this section over to the right, do you think it's just because they didn't finish it?
Probably. When you think of all of these cliff dwellings, and there are 600 in Mesa Verde, these are not isolated villages. There is constant communication going on between them. They are talking to each other. And they are part of a much larger trade network throughout the Southwest. And archaeologists have found things here like macaw feathers, copper bells, cacao beans, seashells, and that shiny black rock called obsidian. Now, none of those things occur here naturally, right? They were all traded for in this trade network. And when they're exchanging goods back and forth, what else do you think they're sharing?
Information.
Information, right. And they find out the drought is not as severe further south. In fact, there's a river, we today call it the Rio Grande, that you can settle next to and irrigate your crops. They've been hunting rabbits and squirrels, and they find out there are bison herds in eastern New Mexico. That's a game changer, right? That is what attracted the people to live in these places, and they never came back to live here again. Today, there are 27 tribes or pueblos that trace their ancestry back to the ancestral Pueblo that lived here originally. These places, as I mentioned earlier, are still very spiritually important to them. They believe the spirits of their ancestors are still here, making these places very much alive. And did you notice the feathers on the bottom here? They are not there by accident. Those are turkey feathers. And they were left by some indigenous people about a month ago now, and they were left as prayer offerings to their ancestors. And they also leave things like tobacco, corn, cornmeal, all as prayer offerings. Any questions?
I Are you seeing it?
Maybe it was.
No, I want to see the handprint. Well, that's the handprint. But there's hieroglyphics, what is it called? See the corner of the square there? Well, this is where the she's there.
It's not in their language, it has been translated
as ancient. Another fire pit, probably?
You know, some archaeologists think that was a grinding place.
Okay.
So these are the Manos and Metates. Are you familiar with that?
Yeah, the Mano
is the hand rock.
Hence Mano.
And the Metate is what you're grinding on.
Okay.
So you're actually putting corn on top of the Metate and grinding back and forth with the Mano.
When I was a kid, I swear they used to let you try.
I bet they did.
Yeah. Well, if you suck, I'm even hurry.